Hey guys, welcome to my third block of Where To. Today I want to tell you something about the first part of Cantabria. Yeah, Cantabria. Cantabria starts from Bilbao. It's the next part of Spain from the Basque Country. And once you have been in Bilbao in the surf spots, I told you before in the last vlog, you can go to Cantabria. Cantabria is a super nice place. It's pretty cool beaches and nice waves. So when you come from Bilbao, there are a lot of small surf spots. You can check it. You can just drive by the coast road and have a look, and you can find some pretty lonely beaches and nice waves. But I want to tell you about some special beaches and special waves. So far I checked them out and they are pretty good and pretty nice. If you go from Bilbao, you go to Laredo at first. It's about 90 to 100 kilometers from Bilbao. And you have to drive by car on the highway. It's a super, super awesome, wonderful highway because you are driving close to the sea and you have an awesome view, an awesome sight of on the sea, and it looks pretty nice. Laredo is a pretty big town. It's more a holiday resort where all the Spanish people go, and you have everything in there what you need. You have camping sites, you have parking conditions, but parking just for the day. So to sleep there is not that easy. You have to look for a spot somewhere in the city and sleep there for the night. It's not that nice for camping in your van, but it's nice to surf. And yeah, supermarkets, everything you need you will find there. And pretty nice waves for sure. You have big open beach break, and it's a kilometer and a half wide, and you have several peaks. On the western end you have a fast left breaking wave, super nice, pretty fast. It's kind of long and it can give you a lot of fun. In the middle there are some different peaks. It's yeah, in the summertime and the weekends it's pretty crowded in Laredo, but it's nice to surf. It's so big and so wide, so it's not too crowded, but it's crowded. On the western end you have the left, and it's super fast and kind of hollow sometimes. In the middle you have some A-frames, some different peaks like a beach breakers, and it's for beginners, intermediates and professionals as well. On the east end you have a nice ride, and yeah, it's also pretty crowded and good people are in there, like in the left on the west end. So in the both left and the right there are pretty good surfers inside, but you can go into the middle. It depends on what you want. So like everywhere, just follow the rules, everything will be cool and will be fine. It's a nice flare in there, and it's yeah, it's in between some mountains. You can see the highway, and it's a cool place to be. La Fortaleza is a point break. Fortaleza is like 30-40 kilometers from Laredo, and yeah, it's a small town, pretty small. You can park everywhere, you can sleep for the night, pretty nice atmosphere in there, but there's kind of localism. It's not for beginners, it's only for intermediates and professionals. It's a left point break. It gets pretty big in there, but it's slow, it's easy. You can also go with a longboard and have pretty nice long ride. Next, there's coming Ajo. Ajo is a very, very small town in the middle of some cows, and you can see some fields in the back and the mountains, and very awesome place to be. It's yeah, it's a small town. There is a camping site, you can camp there, or you can also sleep with your van next to the beach. You can stay on some cliffs, have a super nice view and sunset views. It's super nice to be in there. Ajo is kind of a swell magnet, and if it's everywhere too small, go to Ajo. Ajo is almost every time there's a wave you can surf. It's kind of a beach break. It's different peaks. You have a left, you have a right, you have some A-frames. It depends on the sandbars. You have everything in Ajo what you need, like shops, supermarkets, surf shop. There's everything. It's small, but it's nice atmosphere in there. Galisano. It's yet in the middle of nowhere. It's a super nice surf. It's a river mouth and it's coming into the sea, and there are super clean waves, and you will have everything you need. You have a parking place just yeah, close to the beach. You just have to walk a few meters down to the beach. You can sleep there for the night. Supermarkets are nearby, like 2 kilometers far away, and it's a pretty small beach. It's a super, super nice beach. You're in between some cliffs, and you are like in the middle of nowhere. You can't call it a town. Just a few houses somewhere in some fields between cows. Super nice. You can surf there, you can stay there with your van. Supermarkets are like 2 kilometers far away. There's no camping, but in the evening you can build your tent and sleep somewhere where no one can see you. So it's okay to sleep there and to stay there. Pretty nice place. But for me, the best place, it's close to Galisano. It's called Langre. Langre is a wider, bigger beach. It's surrounded by a big cliff, like 50 meters high. You can stay with your van on top of the cliff and have a view all over the beach. And it's super, super awesome to stay there. In the morning when you wake up, you look over the beach. It's wide, you can see the waves, some surfers already surfing. In the evening, you have the sunset. It's a super nice atmosphere. For me, it's one of the nicest beaches in that area because it has some special flair in there. There are always people sleeping, and all the people I met there were super nice and super friendly, and we had cool evenings making some bonfires and hearing some music. In the morning we went for a surf together. Super cool. The waves are super nice. There's a ride on the east end of the bay. It can be pretty fast, very nice wave, and in all in between that big and all on the beach there are several peaks. The waves are kind of slow, even when it gets bigger and bigger and bigger, like 3 meters high. Normally it can be a super dangerous race, 3 meters, but in Langre it's different. Even if it's big, it's kind of slow and easy to make a takeoff. And if you're lucky, you have a super long way from the one end to the other end of Langre beach. And it's sometimes kind of crowded. It's crowded like there are some surf schools, there are some locals inside. But if you're there during the week time, it's no problem. I often surfed there just with 3 or 2 people in the water, and it was an awesome session. So have a look for Langre. Langre is super nice. Langre is for me the place to be in Cantabria. The thing in Langre is there's no camping site. If you have a tent, it's not that easy to build it up in there. You need a camper van to stay at the beach. There's a camping site, but it's 2.5 kilometers far away. It's in Loredo. Not Laredo, Loredo. It's a small town. There's a small hotel. There's a super small supermarket, some restaurants. Nice atmosphere in there. You can go there in the evening to drink some beers and go for food. They have nice burgers, nice tapas, like everything you need. And it's typical Spanish food as well. And there's a surf shop. It's called Contiki Surf. Super nice. He makes awesome wooden shaped boards by himself, and just check it out. If you're staying in Langre, the waves are often pretty perfect. It needs a little bit bigger swell, like 3 to 4 feet, but if the swell is good, it's super nice to surf there. But there's one option to do. In the morning, you can go over to Loredo. Loredo has also a super, super, super big wide beach. It's like a few kilometers, like 4 or 5 kilometers wide beach with a look on Santander. And in the morning, when there's no wind, the wave is a little bit faster and cleaner in Loredo. If you go down to the beach in Loredo, just keep left, going like 150 meters in front of the dunes, there's a super nice wave, but it's only working in the morning from sunrise till 11. Maybe 12, but it's better if you're there in the morning. So grab your car in the morning if you're sleeping at Langre, go to Laredo, walk to the left and surf that wave. Once you surf that wave, you go there every morning because it's totally different to Langre, but it's super nice. In the evening, Langre, and then during the daytime, it's a lot better because it's a little bit hidden from the wind and it's super nice waves. Close to Loredo, there's Somo. Somo is a more touristical place. There are a lot of hostels, hotels, camping site, there are supermarkets, a lot of surf shops. It's just a few hundred meters at the beach, close to the wave in Laredo. It's not far away, and yeah, you also have the view to Santander on that big open beach break. Super nice wave, but there's more crowded as Loredo. Even if it's just a few hundred meters, but it's more crowded because it's more the touristical place. It's nice to be there in the evening or in the night. You can have there a lot of parties and have fun, or you can go to Santander and have party in there, go for some cocktails. Santander is pretty cheap and it's a nice place. That was the first part of Cantabria, from Bilbao to Somo. If you have any questions, just ask me and give me an email so I can answer you. I hope it could help you. See you next week with the next part of Cantabria. Bye bye.